In this video, you will see how to configure Atomic Mail Sender. After you installed the program, you will see a configuration wizard. Make sure your firewall or antivirus software does not block internet access for the mail sender. Then, enter your default contact information, which will be used for sending emails. In this step, you need to enter your SMTP information. Type the SMTP server name in the text box, or use presets for some free email services. Then, double-click the SMTP server name and check the settings. Usually, SMTP providers publish instructions on how to configure mailing software on their websites. Most servers require authentication. Choose ESMTP if in doubt. Enter your login, password, and your email address. Make sure you set the number of threads to 1, as most SMTP servers allow only one thread. SMTP servers have speed limits and they will not relay your mail if you are sending too many emails too fast. After the initial configuration, go to Mail Sender's Settings. You will need to set custom halo. Check the Detect link and you will be taken to the developer's website. Copy the host name and paste it into the program. When you are sending too many emails to one server in a short period of time, it can block your IP address. Use domain throttle feature to avoid blacklisting. Again, make sure multi-threaded send is unchecked when you are sending via SMTP. If you need to email more than your SMTP server allows you to send, you can add more servers. Let's add another server to the list. You can check this box and SMTP servers will rotate. For example, after sending 3 emails through one SMTP, the program will send the next 3 messages through another server. Advanced users may want to change their DNS settings, and they can do that here. Atomic Mail Sender supports SOX 4 or SOX 5 proxies, including proxy servers that require authentication. You can import proxies from a text file instead of adding them one by one. You can automatically rotate proxies after sending the specified number of messages. Another tab for advanced users, custom headers. And the last tab is for miscellaneous settings. For more tutorial videos, visit www.massmailsoftware.com.